must be delighted.
Yeah, as you said, obviously I've committed with the club for 3 years. Obviously, going forward now is a chance for me to go forward and make long-term plans, and all being well, I can bring the success to the club that it deserves.
What was the draw for you to committing yourself to the football club?
No, obviously, when I first had a discussion with Spencer, it was pretty straightforward. It was easily done within a couple of hours. I was just chatting. Obviously, the club have backed me on what I've done so far, and obviously we've bought into each other. Obviously, from speaking with the board, I've got an open relationship with the board. Great communications with Spencer all the time on what we wanted, what I've wanted to do so far with the squad. They've backed me on players getting in. Obviously, my decision to get players out, and obviously, as I said, going forward, to commit to the club for the next 3.5 years. Obviously, it's great for myself, but obviously, it gives me a chance to look at long-term plans and build the club.
Of course, you know the club inside out, having played for 5 years. So, this is a club that you seem to have at heart, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. As you said, I played here for 5 years. As a player, I gave everything. And as I said, from the manager, from the day one when I got here, I'll give everything I can for the football club. And as I said, 3 years, we can get some plans and we can lay some great foundations for the club now to go forward, and all being well, in these 3 years, we can achieve the objective of getting the club back where it needs to be, and sooner the better.
You mentioned making plans. You came to the club a few months ago when it seemed to be quite dark times, and all of a sudden there seemed to be a bit of light at the end of the tunnel at the moment.
Yeah, obviously the club weren't in a great place, or else I wouldn't have been here. Asked to take the job on. Obviously, it's not just down to myself. There's loads of people that are working hard behind the scenes. Obviously, Andy, my assistant, Andy stepped up from his job with the youth team and helping me going forward, helping the club go forward. And obviously, as you said, I've been at the club, I've association with the club now for nearly 6 years. Obviously, Andy's been here. He's a Wrexham lad. Obviously, there's people in charge of the club that care for the club.
It's not just yourself who's signed. We've recently had Mark Carrington revealed tonight that Leo Smith's also signed a new 2-year deal, so it's great to tie those players down now and think towards not just what's going to happen next season, but what we do going into the summer as well.
Yeah, definitely. As you said, obviously, Cara's a great pro. He's been at the football club the last couple of years. He knows what the football club's about, and he knows what the passion is for the football club and the fans. So, Cara, he's unbelievable in the changing room, he's great around the place, and on the football pitch he offers me options in different positions. He can play it right back, he can play anywhere across the middle of the park. As he showed a couple of years ago, he played off the front line over at Stoke. So as a coach and as a manager, he's somebody that you look at in your changing room, you think he's a great player. He helps me in many different ways. Obviously the Leo one, when we got a job and I came in, obviously chatting with Andy, chatting with Joey, I asked about the young players, obviously came into the squad, it was completely clean slate for everybody, and obviously asked what we had in the youth team, what was ready to step up, and obviously Leo was one. Obviously we couldn't get Jordan Davis in the team quick enough. Obviously we've got George Harry now. Big Ollie Marks will be getting in there soon as well. So obviously the lads have came in, he's took his chance, and he's been outstanding on the 10 games that he's played, and he fully deserved his 2 years. So obviously now he can rebuild on that, on what he's done so far, and go forward.
Went to rebuilding, build the budget was announced this evening. It's a great chance for us now to give us that money that we're looking now to push forward, and it gives you the options that you need for going into the summer and making plans and doing what you can next season.
Yeah, definitely. As you said, it's to go on top of the budget of what we'll get to recruit the players, but obviously anything extra, and if the fans, whatever they can give, obviously everybody has outgoings first. If they can spare anything, it'll be greatly accepted. And obviously, as I said, I'm just representing the football club as good as I can, but it's not just about me, it's about everybody, it's about the town, to get all being well, we can pull together and get the best team out there and get the club the success it deserves.
Yeah, it just proves that fan power, doesn't it? Because obviously you came here, and since you've been here, the fans have taken over. They've transformed the club. So do you have a message for them over what they've achieved over the last few years? And it's just the latest of superb thing that they've managed to do.
Yeah, I can't. One thing that sticks with me throughout my whole career is the fact that when we wasn't get paid and the fans were walking across Colliers and you could see them putting money in buckets and people were bringing money, so obviously we hadn't been paid for a month. And then I think I realised then what kind of special place this was, and obviously what it means to what the football club means to the fans. So all being well, I can achieve something with their backing, and obviously as I said, as a football club we can achieve what we want to achieve, and that's going back to the Football League.
Now going, obviously, finally you've extended this contract, the first game you've got it's a very tough one, Aldershot Town on Saturday.
Yeah, definitely. As you said, Aldershot Town, they're just on the verge of the playoffs. I know Gary Waddock well, played under him for a couple of months, so I know how he gets his teams and how they're playing, their attacking team, and it'll be a test for us. And we've done okay lately. Obviously, we're in great form at home. Obviously, we're a decent point down at Dover, but obviously, we're back at home and we know it's going to be a test. They're a very good team and they're going to offer a lot of problems to us. All being well, we can come through and can get 3 points.
Thanks, Dean. Congratulations.
Cheers, thanks a lot.